My name is Lenny Rosakara, and I will tell you about our engineering research with Future Engineering Skip on the network update program for software-defined networks. There are many events that may cause the necessity to change configurations in networks, and network updating is any such change of configurations. And every time a controller must give an appropriate response to such an event, that is, it must provide safe and correct changing of configurations. And so the network update problems, these are the problems of array and same array configuration of network. I'll consider this problem from the mathematical point of view, excuse me, in advance. And to the end, first of all, I will give a short introduction to the formal model of SDN. Next, in the framework of this model, I will set up for a number of network update problems depending on the reality. Then I'll show that in some cases, some variants of these problems can be solved rather efficiently with the help of the so-called tagging techniques. Questions that are focused in our research are two. First of all, what means are necessary and sufficient for achieving correct and safe updating? And the second question, how much efficiently this can be done? And therefore, the main part of my talk will concern such issue as is it necessary to use technique always to achieve a correct solution of the update problem. We show that for the one of the most weak variant of such problem, the problem of recovering such configurations, it is possible in some cases to solve the update problem without using tagging technique, not always. So, I give some brief survey of the formal model we used in our research, and this is not a new model. It is used very widely in many papers on network verification and network updating. So in this model, we deal with abstract entities concerning the elements of software-defined networks. The packets are completely specified by their headers, and a network is composed of switches. Every switch has a number of ports. Some ports are connected with each other by channels or links, but there are also some ports that are connected with the outside world. These are so-called ingress ports. And the packets, all packets, inbound to the network via the ingress ports and go out via another ingress ports. The position of a packet in a network is completely defined by its state. In the framework of the whole network, it is a global state, and if only one switch is concerned, then it is a local state. Packets are processed by forwarding rules. In our model, each rule is specified by a triangle. The first component of this triangle is a guard. In fact, this is a predicate, any predicate on the set of headers. But this is an abstraction of a so-called forwarding rule template. This guard selects which packets should be processed by this rule and which not. Only those packets that satisfy this predicate are processed by the rule. The action is an abstraction of a list of instructions where each instruction processes the packet by either sending its copy to this or that port of the switch or by changing somehow some fields in the packet header. And the third component of the rule is a priority. It is used to resolve the collisions when several rules may be applicable to the same packet. As a result, the semantics of forwarding rule may be viewed as a binary relation on a set of local states of the packets. Flow table viewed as an unordered set of forwarding rules, and the relation which is implemented by this table may be viewed as a union of the relations, of the binary relations corresponding to the forwarding rules, but the priority should be taken into account. That is, the highest priority rules is applied first, and then in the descending order, the other rules also may be applied to some packets. The model of the whole network is specified by a pair. The first component of this pair is a description of the whole chain, and the second component is the assignment of flow tables to network switches. And as soon as this specification is given, then the semantics of our model may be computed as a composition of binary relation computed by individual flow table and by the topology relation. This is a so-called one-hop forwarding relation. It specifies how the global states of the packets are changed in the course of the what's moving through the network. The most important property of a network can be defined in terms of the paths, since from the outside observer, the content of the flow tables, the structure of the net is not so much important, but the most important feature is what are the rules these packets follows through the network from one ingress port to another ingress port, and that is the sequence of global states such that the first state of this sequence is always a state which component is an egress port, is egress point. And each next element of this sequence is was obtained from the application of some forwarding rule. And these sequences are either infinite, this is a loop call, or it ends in some output egress port. Now, when we consider the means used by controller to modify, to change configurations of a network, these are commands. We consider three types of commands, one for addition of a certain rule to a certain flow table. Some rules may be deleted from the flow table of a switch. And they also can be defined. Beyond the configuration commands, there are also other means that may be used by a controller to update network configurations. These means include using of priority. Different priority may be assigned to data, metadata, can be used to label the certain fields in the federal packets. Control can be relies also on the some kind of synchronization commands like FireGear. This command divides the sequence of packets in two parts, and the second part is applied only at the completion of the first part. There are also other means, but I confine myself in my consideration only the first four types. As for reconfiguration, as for update of the reconfiguration, then as soon as such int appears, then controller must generate a sequence of reconfiguration commands. And using the synchronization pin, I may consider this sequence of commands as a partially ordered set, since such messages, such commands as barrier, insert some order in the application of these commands. And that reconfiguration patch in our mathematical model may be viewed as any partially ordered set of reconfiguration commands, and this is the only mean which we will use in the solution of this problem. Now, in the most general terms, network update program can be defined as follows. Suppose we have some initial configuration C0, and we have two requirements. One of them is a post condition. This is a target requirement. We want that as a result of our update, we have to achieve a configuration which satisfies this post condition. And another requirement is invariant. We also should be aware that in the course of our reconfiguration, every intermediate configuration should satisfy this invariant. And these post conditions and invariants, we may obtain a whole line, a number of different, more specific network update problems. One of them is a problem of network synthesis. Given a post condition, we would like to build such a configuration which satisfies this post condition. Although this is the maybe the most short in its definition variant of network update program, it is not very easy to solve it, taking into account that this post condition is defined in terms of some logic or in some algebraic terms. And to the extent of my knowledge, I know only one paper which deals with this variant of the problem. Although this this approach is rather straightforward and maybe some may, but nevertheless it was very, and using an exhaustive search, they present some procedure for the solution of this problem. But the most well-known and mostly studied variant of this program, the network update program, is the variant of global network update. Given an initial configuration and a target configuration, we have two configurations, we must change the initial configuration in such a way that in the course of this change in the intermediate configurations, only those paths may appear that are available in one of these two configurations, either in the source or in the target. This program was studied and successfully in many papers, and I will speak about one possible solution to this problem a bit later. But there is also another branch of network update problem, a local update. This is a variant when we want just to change one specific root in our network, and this can be formally defined in similar terms. One of the most weak variants of the network update program, this is a variant we will deal with, network recovery. Suppose that we have a configuration and assume that for this and that reason, maybe say because of the expiration of timeouts, some routes, some forwarding routes were deleted from the flow tables. And afterward, we want to restore our configuration. So we have an initial configuration. We have a set of rules we must to add to some flow tables. And the aim is to add these rules in such a way that no other paths than those that may be in the initial or the target configuration appear in the course of our update. The last maybe but not least, you may see that the flow table optimization problem is also is a kind of network, it's a network update problem. In this case, our aim is to change the content of flow tables in such a way that minimize some target function, maybe this function is the space consumed by the forwarding routes, but in such a way that to preserve the set of paths that are defined by this configuration. Now I'll show that the problem of global configuration can be solved rather easily with the use of so-called tags. Suppose that vacant field which can be labeled tagged by some mark, and every time this mark is either 1 or 0, and suppose that we have a configuration which is organized in such a way that every tag which can come from the outside to the network, first of all tag 1 is assigned to this reserved field of the packet header, and all the, those packets that are marked by 1 are processed by the forwarding rules in this configuration. And after all, when this packet is delivered to the ingress port, the final ingress port, this tag is disappeared. In this case, if we want to make a change in our configuration, first of all, we insert desirable forwarding rules of a new configuration in the inner flow tables, but we modify these rules so that they could operate only with the packets with another tag. This is the first phase. And the second phase, we modify the rules at the border flow tables and at the flow tables of the border switches, so that they assign another tag to the packets arrived at the network. And thus our configuration step by step is switched from the initial to the target. And finally, we delete the useless forwarding rules of the initial configuration. In such a way, we can safely and correctly transform one configuration into the arbitrary another configuration. We wonder if this tagging technique is always necessary for the solution of network update problem. Are there any cases when we can solve this problem without tagging? And we, this is a theorem which states the
the songs I told you.
And so we turn to the network recovery program. Well, it is defined as follows. Suppose that we have some configuration C prime, and this C prime configuration includes some set of forwarding rules. And suppose that these rules somehow disappeared in our configuration C prime, and we want to restore it now. But to restore in such a way that no new additional rules that appear in the course of our restoration. And we found that in some cases this restoration can be done, this restoring can be done rather easily. Suppose that we define a specific relation on the set of rules we want to restore. We say that one rule depends on the other if the former rule is applied to the packets only after the latter in some path in some path through our network. And if our initial configuration, our target configuration, if our target configuration has only forwarding rules of the same priority, and this dependency order on the set of rules insert is a partial order, then a very simple configuration batch can be used to give a solution to our problem. But in some cases, this is not possible. Consider, for example, it is not maybe easy to see the indices of my formula. But suppose that we have some such configuration where there are two rules which may disappear. We want to insert it, but I think that 2 or 3 minutes will be sufficient to understand that the order of the insertion is no matter, since in every case we cannot give a solution, a correct solution to this problem. If we don't use priorities, but if a certain theorem formally gives an answer to this question, no matter which reconfiguration batch we use, it doesn't give a solution to the network recovery problem for this specific measure. But if we use priorities, then we can split some rules in such a way that this pair of new rules totally achieve the same effect as the initial rule, but they have different guards, so that each portion of packets is processed either by one splitting rule or by the other. And we proved that no matter which configuration we have, if it is free from the forwarding loops, then we can split the rules we want to insert in such a way that in the set of the splitting rule we have a partially ordered dependency relation. And combining this result with our previous theory, we obtain a solution to the network recovery problem with the using of priorities in the case when our configuration we deal with contains only forwarding rules which have the same priority. But for the auxiliary purposes, we may use multiple priorities. Okay, but even in this case, this is not a complete solution. Suppose that our configurations use until then, forwarding rules with multiple solutions. As for example, in this case, these rules, one of these rules have high priority, and another is rule of low priority. And then, if in the configuration we want to restore, there are rules with multiple priorities, then we cannot guarantee the solution of our problem, even with using splitting and multiple priorities in our rules. In some cases, or some examples of configurations, network recovery problem cannot be solved by our means and some other techniques like tagging is necessary. There are also questions that remain open. We think that sooner or later we will give answer to this question. What are the cases, which are the cases when we can solve more general problems without tagging, and what are necessary and sufficient conditions for the solution of network recovery problem without tagging. But you see that, not in all cases, but sometimes we can avoid using some auxiliary fields, packet headers, and can apply some more sophisticated techniques for network update without tagging. Thank you very much for your patience.
Certain technique, certain is possible to reduce the complexity.
做这个之外，我们的 most of the most 就是。
There are a couple more questions. I'm interested in what's the main use case of such techniques of replication. It's needed when the network working in some debug mode or it's working in normal mode. Because it seems to me that it depends on how fast and the frequency how we need to do this verification. So you suppose the network work in some testing mode and we just want to find some errors, or it's a normal mode and we do this verification every time the state of network is changing. Thank you.
Excuse me, please, what do you mean by the verification?
I'd name verification these techniques that you call the network recovery. So the word recovery means that the network works in debug mode or something else.
I see. Certainly this is a mathematical result or a mathematical model, since in real life it is very hard to find the time when such recovery to launch. Since in the course of the various recovery, some changes in the network may occur. And therefore, suppose that the controller successfully compute the configuration batch on the solution of our problem. But while this batch is delivering to the switches, certainly in the switches some changes may occur, and this solution certainly will be not correct for the real configuration we are taking.
If I understood it right, in this paper, we have found a solution to update the non-disruptive update of the network when the network conforms to some rules. So any feasible commercial product based on this would fall into categories. First of all, it will not work on some configurations. Or it would need to implement some backup technique to handle the configurations, which couldn't be solved this way. So expanding the scope this way, are there any advantages of using this technique? So actually, do you know of the networks which will definitely be solvable? So you can have to sell this thing to the customer. I know that your network is okay, so please use our other. Or it's faster, or so you solve your problem your way, so that you find it's impossible to switch to something which is more cumbersome. Or it's just limitation. We don't know what you need to do.
Well, maybe I tell about my regard to this problem. I think that must be supplied with some library functions, then that can solve typical problems that may occur in the course of network working. One of such problems is suppose that application knows solution to some configuration, but how this solution can be delivered and implemented in the network? The application must not know anything about the real state of affairs on network, and it must not pay attention to such questions as the order of the order of reconfiguration commands that must be provided, and in these cases, such a petition. For example, just give a solution as like this set of commands must be delivered and performed in the network switches. But the way of delivering and the order in which they being set to these switches, this is up on the this librarian procedure. And our aim in this case is to build a variety of such algorithm procedures which can be given to a controller to solve such typical standard problems.
But there are unsolvable cases. So how you envision this thing working? Just makes the ideal transition in most cases and transition the gray in the worst cases. So, there's a question. I would like to use the opportunity.